haven't done one of these videos in a while, and I've been thinking about it, but I really wanted to talk about, I have made one video on how much Johan, my kitty cat, loves raw food, and he was meowing his little head off, and that hasn't changed. I mean, sometimes I think, oh, maybe he wants a different flavor, but then he's like, no, I want this, and I've kind of tweaked the diet a little bit. I noticed that I used to have to rely on laxatives for him because he has IBD, inflammatory bowel disease, very similar to Crohn's disease and sometimes lymphoma. But anyway, so he used to rely on laxatives and he doesn't rely on them anymore. So they're expired. I know that the shelf life for Restore Lax is like a year, but, you know, he's doing really well. Their poops, they don't poop as often, and their poops are harder, but that's actually normal for raw diet, and he's not acting like he's upset or anything. Sometimes he meows a little bit in the box when he goes poop, but he always did that. So it may be more like he had enlarged anal glands. The vet doesn't want to keep expressing them, so other than that, he's perfectly normal, and I keep trying to buy things for my kitties. Like, I had the exercise wheel that I made some videos about, and I bought this little cave, and I took the blanket out and I put it on the couch because the blanket, or whatever you call it, is very soft, and they like to lie on the floor on that. And we have in Canada this indigenous site called Shades of Gray. Yeah, that better be it. And I just ordered some strips and rabbit's feet and some toppers for the raw food. And I hope he likes it. I don't want to make him all tubby because I know the vet is really concerned about weight and this and that. And you know, the vet doesn't even know he's on a raw diet. And I talk to them as if he's still on his normal diet that she put him on, where he had to rely on laxatives and all that sort of thing. But they don't, vets generally don't believe in raw diets because, well, it could cause parasites or salmonella. I'm actually giving him, you know, substitutes, like, for his bowel, like a second probiotic that I'm buying, with, that's, called S. Buardi. S means something, too. And it's working on a different part of the bowel, and I can give him his, he's taking another probiotic from the vet, and, sorry, I can't think when I'm doing these videos, but yeah, but they can work in sync, and they can take you taking them at the same time, it doesn't matter. I'm also giving him taurine and Enjavita yeast and like eggshells powdered because he spits out the bones in the raw, and he's getting krill oil and chia seeds and pumpkin, and I cook the egg, which he likes. I was trying to eat an egg myself today, and he comes running over and he's trying to get it out of my, you know, in my lap, like, so that's really cute because I never would have thought that, because at first if you put a cat down a plate of raw, they'll just walk away. Put an egg down, they'll just walk away, but then they can get used to it sometimes. And I'm not suggesting you do this, because for me, I spent a few years just reading about it through Dr. Karen Becker, and I know My Cat from Hell guy has a couple of videos, so it's, and there are a couple other vets that do, and then the rest don't want to even broach the subject. It does worry me when I go to the vet next, She, my vet has already said she's had a couple of clients with raw, even though she doesn't agree with it. But I just, it's really hard. But I love my cat, and I just, you know, she can do the diagnosis. Like the raw diet, it's gonna cost me, it's costing me more money anyways. And if she does the diagnostics, that's like $500. And like, but if she has to check him and make sure he's okay, like, I'm gonna say, yeah, like, that'll be covered by my pet insurance, which is a great thing to have. Pet insurance does not cover the vet visits themselves, but you'd have to say, like, what is wrong with them. Like, something has to be wrong, illness or something, you know? But anyway, I have my Christmas tree, as you can see. I'm kind of sad because my mom doesn't want to decorate this year or do Christmas, and I don't live with her. She lives alone now that my stepdad died a year ago. But anyway, we still talk on the phone a lot, so I think she's doing okay. It's just she doesn't want to go through all that big work, and she's got a big tree, and I just got a little tree, and I got my Christmas lights on for in the window for the outside people. So anyway, it's really exciting. I'm kind of feeling like I'm in a funk lately. Just lazy, but I mean, I don't lie in bed. I do things. I occupy my time. I watch a lot of YouTube videos. I don't do much, but anyways, have a good season, folks, whatever you're celebrating, because there's more than just Christian religions.